Hello friends, welcome back to another episode by Engineering Today, and hope you're all having a great time. The SpaceX Starbase facility in Boca Chica, Texas, continues to buzz with activity as the aerospace company's ambitious projects unfold. Recent news updates shed light on various developments at the facility, from rocket de-stacking to the impressive capabilities of the Tesla Cybertruck. One of the recent highlights at the Starbase facility involves Ship 25 being de-stacked from Booster 9. SQD has been disengaged from S-25, and employees are applying tape to cover the connection ports in preparation for the de-stacking process. This move hints at a probable removal of the hot staging ring from the top of B-9, suggesting that SpaceX is continuously fine-tuning its rocket technology for optimal performance. Furthermore, there are indications of similar activities involving Ship 26 and its connection to SQUID. This prompts questions about the purpose of these disconnections. Are they preparing for static fire tests and upcoming closures? Or is it to facilitate the removal of the HSR from B-9? Speculations are running high as SpaceX enthusiasts eagerly await updates. In a scene that could have been plucked from an Elon Musk-produced sci-fi film, a Tesla Cybertruck was recently spotted at the Starbase facility. What makes this sighting even more thrilling is the fact that the Cybertruck was towing a massive rocket engine on a trailer. This engine is none other than the Raptor vacuum engine, designed for the second stage of SpaceX's Starship launch system, and it reportedly weighs about 1,600 kilograms. While the Cybertruck has been seen towing various trailers in the past, this instance marked the first time it pulled a SpaceX rocket engine. The Cybertruck's impressive towing capacity, reportedly over 14,000 pounds depending on the model, makes it a perfect match for SpaceX's heavy lift rockets. Elon Musk's vision of synergy between his companies, with both Tesla and SpaceX utilizing the same stainless steel alloy, is coming to fruition. The Cybertruck's stainless steel body is claimed to be bulletproof to a 9mm handgun, mirrors the same alloy SpaceX intends to use for its Starship spacecraft. This synergy highlights Musk's relentless pursuit of innovation and integration across his ventures. In another significant development, a 12-hour closure window has been announced for next Monday, Tuesday, or Wednesday. This indicates a resurgence of the testing phase at Starbase, pointing to increased activity and a commitment to refining their technology further. The aerospace company has always been known for its rigorous testing procedures, ensuring the utmost safety and efficiency of its rockets. Additionally, on October 4th, observers spotted a B-9 grid fin wiggle test. Grid fins play a crucial role in guiding and stabilizing rockets during descent, particularly in the controlled landing phase. As SpaceX continues to iterate on its rockets and spacecraft, the synergy between the Tesla Cybertruck and SpaceX's stainless steel-clad Starship highlights Elon Musk's overarching vision of creating a sustainable and interlinked future for space exploration and electric vehicles. Also, Elon Musk took the stage at the International Astronautical Congress 2023 in Azerbaijan to discuss the latest developments of the world of space exploration, with a particular focus on the ambitious Starship project. Musk's presence at the event generated significant anticipation and excitement, and his talk didn't disappoint, shedding light on some crucial aspects of SpaceX's future endeavors. One of the key highlights of Musk's speech was his revelation about the thrust capabilities of the Starship's booster. He announced that the thrust on the booster is trending towards a remarkable 50% increase compared to its current capacity, thanks to ongoing improvements in the Raptor engine. This boost in thrust is a significant development and will play a pivotal role in enhancing the overall performance of Starship. Musk also discussed the evolving role of the upper stage in the Starship system. He emphasized that the upper stage will gradually assume more of the Delta V load, reducing the workload on the booster. This optimization means that the booster will only need to burn for approximately 100 seconds during a launch, a stark contrast to the longer burn times of current SpaceX rockets. Elon Musk's ambition to land Starship on Mars within the next 3 to 4 years remains undeterred. However, he acknowledged that the success of this mission largely hinges on SpaceX's ability to prove the concept of orbital refueling. Orbital refueling is the key to extending Starship's range and capabilities, as it enables the spacecraft to travel deeper into space and reach distant destinations like Mars. Musk recognizes that this aspect is the long pole in the journey to Mars. Musk hinted at the possibility of ocean-based launch platforms for Starship. He remarked that even launching the Starship from Cape Canaveral a few times a day would be insufficient to meet their ambitious goals. The idea of ocean-based launch platforms is intriguing, as it would allow for more frequent and flexible launches, minimizing disruptions caused by weather and other logistical constraints. SpaceX's vision for Starship involves launching it more than 1,000 times a year. While this number may seem staggering, it follows the trend set by the Falcon 9 rockets. SpaceX had demonstrated its ability to achieve high launch frequencies, and this goal aligns with its commitment to making space travel more routine and accessible. Musk also touched upon SpaceX's plans to expand its presence at Cape Canaveral in Florida. He mentioned the possibility of a greenfield launch pad, signaling the company's commitment to further utilizing the spaceport for Starship missions. This expansion aligns with SpaceX's strategy to have multiple launch sites to support their ambitious launch cadence. Perhaps one of the most audacious statements made by Musk was his belief that we are less than 10 years away from hosting an International Astronautical Congress in space. While this might sound overly optimistic, it underscores the rapid progress being made in the space industry. Technically, SpaceX could already host such an event in space with a small number of attendees, but the cost barrier remains a challenge. The first piece of news revolves around the waiting game SpaceX is playing with the Federal Aviation Administration, or FAA, and the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Services. The anticipation is palpable as the fate of the 2023 launch of Starship hinges on these agencies' reviews. A government shutdown in the U.S. could derail these plans, underscoring the importance of timely approvals. Fortunately, historical data suggests that such shutdowns are relatively rare occurrences, offering a glimmer of hope for space enthusiasts eagerly awaiting Starship's next flight. And that's all for now. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.